Now, brothers and sisters, I'm recommending all of you to study the history of this nation, especially the African Americans. Muslims, how many Muslims here tonight? Raise your hand. I'm recommending that the Muslims, because you're going to find some parallels in the history of the African American and the Muslims right now, things that African Americans suffered from in the 50s and the 60s and the 70s that Muslims are facing right now in this country, and you better understand and appreciate history. Now, here around the country, Obama, going around the country, people voting for him, not just black people, white people, male, female, voting for Obama. There was a time in this country where a black man was not allowed to vote. And why wasn't they allowed to vote? They were not allowed to vote only because of the color of their skin. They were black. And because they were black, they were not allowed the opportunity to vote, which is supposed to be an inherent right of every American citizen. We take now education for granted. There was a man, Mega Evers, a black man who loved education so much that he used to walk 12 miles a day just to go to school. Black people couldn't go to any school. Black people had to go to segregated schools, schools just for black people, inferior schools. And if a black man or black boy or girl tried to go to a school, a white school, they'd get beat upon or spit upon. The government had to make, our government had to make laws to protect the rights of African Americans, and they had to bring National Guards in. To bring National Guards to a school to allow the governor of that state or the mayor of that city allow black children to go in that school. They had to bring a National Guard to do that. You don't understand what happened. You look at America now, but you don't understand the context of America. We used to have a law in this country called reckless eyeballing. You know what reckless eyeballing is? You know what it is? You know what reckless eyeballing is? If a white, if a black man looked at a white woman, he'd go to jail. It's called reckless eyeballing. I'm not making this up. So you now, you get money and you want to live and buy a house. You couldn't do that as a black person. You couldn't buy any house. You couldn't live in any neighborhood because you were discriminated because of your color. And you couldn't live in certain places. This is something that you don't even, you can't even imagine. You're talking about a job that used to say about black people. Black people were the last hired and the first fired. It was true. Black people had the worst jobs, menial jobs. What crime would, did they commit? No crime, except they were black. You have no idea how it was in slavery. You haven't got a clue how it was in slavery. Imagine a man and a wife, husband and wife, separated. Imagine a man and a mother and father separated from their children. You can't even imagine that. We have documents on how black people were sold in slavery, how they were treated in slavery. You're talking about, you know, Muslims. How many of you flew on a plane as a Muslim and you were like profiled? Raise your hand. Right? Now I'm profiled every time I get on a plane. Mr. Wahhaj, your name has been randomly selected. Yeah, right. But what do you do when you do that as a Muslim?
You know, look what they're doing to us. They racially profile.
You think that's something? A resolution was passed by the Senate last year. You know what that resolution was? apologizing to African Americans for not creating laws to stop black people from being lynched. Black people lynched. You know what that's like, man? To see your father hung from a tree? What crime did he commit? He had the audacity to be black. Thousands of black people lynched in this country. Homes destroyed and burned because they're black. Men, black men, gone to their death accused of raping white women. That's the way it was in this society.